State machines are used everywhere, and most of us interact with them on a daily basis, without even realizing it. Every time you withdraw money from the ATM with your bank card, buy train tickets from the ticket machine, or when you use the air conditioner, there is a state machine behind it. In fact, almost every machine uses the function of a state machine. But what is state machine? How does this work? What are the main elements of a state machine? What is the relation between state machine and ReFramework in UiPath? What are the advantages of a state machine? When should I use state machine? What is the difference between state machine, sequence and flowchart? I will answer all these questions in this video. This video is considered an introduction to the ReFramework in UiPath. If you like the video, please share it with your friends and colleagues. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, if you haven't already. Let's start. Let's first take this example as introduction for state machines. Assume we have an ATM. And we want to withdraw money. First, when we want to use the ATM has the status ready. This means that the machine is ready and we can start doing something. First thing we have to do is to put the card in the ATM. Once you put your card, the machine changes the status from ready to a new status. The new status is a menu where you can choose what you want to do. Assume we only have these two options. Withdraw money and check balance. As mentioned, we want to withdraw money. So we choose the first option. The machine changes the status to this one. It asks you to give the amount of money which you want to withdraw. Here you enter the amount. For example, 100. And then you hit OK. Once you clicked on OK, the status of the machines changed to PIN. Here you have to enter your PIN. You give your PIN. And then you hit OK. Once you click on OK, the machine checks your PIN. If the PIN is wrong, the machine asks you to enter your PIN again. If the PIN is correct, the machine status changed to this one. In this case, the machine asks you to take your card. After that, the money comes out of the machine. At the end, once you took the money, the machine status changed again to ready status. Let's now see the process flow, how it looks like. First, we have ready state. In this state, we can enter the credit card. Once we enter the card, the ATM moves on to the next state, choose option. Here we have different options, withdraw money and check balance. If we choose the first option, the state is changed to the next state, enter amount. In this state, we can enter the amount of money, which we want to withdraw. Once we set the amount, the state is changed to the next state, enter PIN. In this state, we have to enter the PIN of the card. Here is the PIN checked, if it's correct. If the PIN is wrong, state is changed again to the same state. Here we can set a condition, that the PIN can be only 3 times entered. If the PIN is correct, the state is changed to the next state, getting money. In this state, we take the card and the money. After that, the state is changed to the first state, ready. The next customer can use the machine. Let's see the second option, check balance. Once we choose this option, the state is changed to state, enter PIN. The PIN is checked here, and if it's wrong, the state is changed to state, enter PIN again. If the PIN is correct, the state is changed to the next state, balance. In this state, we can see our credit card balance. If we don't want to do anything more, we can get the card. But if we want to do something else, we can do it here. I will not add these options to the process flow. It's only to understand the function of a state machine. Assume we don't want to do anything. In this case, we take the card, the state is changed to state ready. As you see, we have different states. In each state, some activities are to be done. Depends on the activities and the results, the state is changed to another state. That's all about this example and state machines in general. Let's now see what does a state machine exactly mean. A state machine is a type of automation that uses a finite number of predefined states and transitions between states. As the definition suggests, state machine consists of two main parts, states and transitions. This means that state machine is a container which consists of states and transitions. The states are in the example of the ATM the following: ready, choose option, enter amount, enter PIN, getting money, balance. The transitions are the arrows, where we move from state to the next one depending on the result of the current state. This means, a transition is like an if statement. Depending on the result of this if statement, we move on to the state, which we defined in the current state. I hope you could now understand the meaning of state machine, and what does state and transition mean. Let's now understand state and transition in details in UiPath. I will explain each part in details, what does it mean and how to use it. In UiPath we have two kinds of states, state and final state. State is a normal state, which can be used in the process and has another states after it. Final state is a state, which can be set at the end of the process. After this state there is no another state. A process must contains at least one final state, but it could also have more than one final state. But what does each state contain? State has two sectors, entry and exit. Entry sector contains the activities, which to be executed, once we enter this state. This means, once we are in a state, each activity in this sector will be executed. Exit sector contains activities, which are to be executed, once we leave the state. This means, that the activities in this sector will be executed after execution of the activities, which are in entry sector. Final state contains only entry sector. There is no exit sector, because as mentioned, this state will be placed at the end of the process, and we don't have any states after this state. We also have another element in the states. It's transition. Transition, as mentioned, is to move from state to another state. Only states has transitions, but final state doesn't have transitions, because as already mentioned, we set this state at the end of the process. Therefore, we don't need any transitions. Transition consists of three parts. Trigger, condition, action. Before I explain these three parts, let me tell you something important here. If we have activities in entry and exit sectors and we also have a transition. In which order are the activities executed? First the activities in entry sector are executed, then the transition is chosen depending on the activities in the entry sector. After that, the activities in exit sector are executed. This means, if we have activities in exit sector, which can change the transition, it doesn't matter and the transition stay the same, without changing the transition. Let's check this example to understand it better. We have here a state machine, which consists of three states. State and two final states. We are now in state activity. We have an entry sector and assign activity, where we set the result variable equal to successful. In the exit sector we have another assign activity, where we set the result variable equal to business rule exception. And we have two transitions. Let's see the conditions of each transition. Transition successful has the following condition. Transition business rule exception has the following condition. When we run the code, which activities are first executed, and which transition should be selected. Let's see. Once we enter this state, the activities in entry sector are executed. In this case, the variable result of type string gets the value successful. After that we should select the transition. As you see, the condition for the first transition is, that result variable should be equal to successful. This is true, therefore we select this transition. After selecting the transition, we go back to the state, and the activities in exit sector are executed. In this case, the result variable has a new value, business rule exception. If we check the condition for the second transition, it's correct. It means, we should select the second transition. But we don't choose the second transition, because we already selected the first transition, depending on the activity in entry sector. It means, that after executing the activities in exit sector, we move on to the state, final state, success. This is very important to know about entry, exit and transition. As mentioned, we have in transition three parts, trigger, condition, and action. Let's now learn more about these three parts. Trigger and action are sectors, where we can add activities to execute. Condition is to select the transition, once the condition is met. But how and in which order are the activities executed? First the activities in trigger sector will be executed. After that, the condition is checked, if it's true. If the condition is true, the transition is selected and then the activities in action sector are executed. But what does happen, if we have more than one transition in a state, and each transition has activities in the trigger sector? Which activities will be executed and in which order? Does the decision for selecting a transition changed, depending on the activities in the trigger sector? Let's understand it using the same example, which I explained already. As explained, we are in the activity state. Entry activities are executed. Result variable has the value successful. After that we go to the transitions. We have two transitions. I added new activities to the transitions. As you see, we have in each transition an activity in trigger sector. What has happened now? Once the activities in entry sector are executed, all activities in each trigger sector is now executed. This means that these two activities are executed. First the activity in the second transition, and then the activity in the first transition. This activity writes this text to the console. The variable result has now a new value, business rule exception. In this case, we move again from this transition to the second transition, because the value is changed and it doesn't meet the condition of the first transition. It means that we select the second transition, not the first transition, because of the activities in trigger sector of the first transition. After that, we go back to the state, the activity in exit sector will be executed. The result variable has now again the same value, business rule exception. Then we go back again to the selected transition. The activities in action sector are executed. After that, we move on to the state, final state, BRE. Let me summarize the execution order of all sectors. Assume we have only one state and two final states. First, the entry sector activities are executed. After that, we go to the transitions. First, each trigger sector activity will be executed. If we have three transitions, the trigger sector of the third transition will be executed. Then the trigger of the second transition. And at the end, the trigger of the first transition. After that, we check the conditions of the transitions. It depends on the activities of the entry and trigger sectors. Now we select the transition. Then we go back to the state activity. Here are the activities in exit sector to be executed. At the end, the activities in the action sector of the selected transition will be executed. And then we move on to the next state, depending on what we defined in the selected transition. I hope you could now understand in which order each sector is executed. I know that the topic is not easy to understand, therefore if you have any question, please write us. We will try to answer your question as soon as possible. You can also join our Facebook group and ask us there. You can find the link in the video description. Now we know, what is state machine and which parts are in it? But why and when we should use state machine? What are the advantages of a state machine? Why we don't use flowchart or sequence? Let's learn more about the advantages of a state machine, and also the difference between state machine, sequence, and flowchart. The first and most important advantage of a state machine is that we can use it for complex processes. If we want to implement a complex process, where we are able to break down a complex process into smaller independent tasks, state machines are very useful. We have also better visualization of the process. State machines make the testing easier, because we don't need to define each test case and also the conditions and results. Without using state machines, we need to implement many if-else conditions, to make sure that code is working fine. But using the state machines, we set the input of the process, and depending on the result, the code is moving from a state to another, as we defined in the state machine. State machines can be highly maintainable. They are also stable and have less prone to change. And the last advantage, which I want to mention in this video, is that state machines are the best art for implementation, if we are working with Qt. It's my opinion. Because using state machines, we can easily manage the Qt items, handle errors and avoid termination because of one single item. Therefore is the UiPath ReFramework implemented using state machine. This means, ReFramework in UiPath is a template, which based on state machine. We have several states and transitions in it. So if you understood the state machines, you can easy work with ReFramework in UiPath. But as promised in the community, I will create a video about ReFramework, how it works and how to use it. You now only need to understand the meaning and function of a state machine. The disadvantage of a state machine is that it's not very easy to implement. You have to know the process very good, and you have to be able to break down the process into many tasks. Once you did it, you can implement it easier. So the effort at the beginning is high. Large state machines with many states and transitions can be difficult to manage and maintain. The graph may start to look like spaghetti. These were the advantages and disadvantages of a state machine. There are sure many other points, which I didn't mention in the video. You can write a comment and mention other important points about state machines. Let's now move to the last point in the video. What is the difference between state machine, flowchart and sequence? Let's start by sequence. Sequences have a simple linear representation of the process. Here are the activities executed from top to bottom. It's best suited for simple scenarios, when activities follow each other. Flowcharts offer more flexibility for connecting activities, because of the two-dimensional manner. Here we can use multiple branching logical operators, which enables us to create complex business processes and connect activities in multiple ways. Flowcharts tend to be used for workflows, which contain multiple decision points. State machine is the third layout, which we can use to implement business processes in UiPath. I think, you now know more about state machines in general and especially in UiPath. Here is to mention, that we use state machines to implement event-driven processes, based on a finite number of states and transitions. By the way, state machines are also called finite state machines. So if you hear the word finite state machine, it means the same like state machine. State machines are best suited for complex and continuous processes. In summary, sequences are for linear processes. Flowcharts for repetitive processes. And state machines for transactional processes. Now we are at the end of this video. As mentioned, this video is an introduction for UiPath ReFramework. Before ending this video, let me shortly summarize the most important points. State machines consist of two parts, states and transitions. We have two kinds of states, state, and final state. The first state in a state machine is called initial state. We could use only one initial state, but we can use infinite number of states. Each state machine must have at least one final state, but it could also have more than one final state. State has three parts, entry, exit and transition. Final state has only entry sector. Transition is to connect the states with each other. Each transition has three parts, trigger, condition, and action. Trigger and action sectors are optional, but condition must be set. ReFramework in UiPath is based on state machine. Thanks for watching. And please subscribe my channel and activate the notification button to be informed once the ReFramework video is published.